Inside Racing is brought to you by Dunlop.
Fast and faster again, lap after lap. Car and driver constantly at the limit. In a development partnership like that between BMW and their tyre partner Dunlop, nothing gets left to chance. The race before the race. Watching, assessing, improving. Constant feedback with drivers and engineers so that the product on the car is the best it can be. Development in motor racing differs only slightly from that for the road. In elaborate speed tests, for example, engineers work out how well the tire sits. Computer designs get transferred direct to high-end milling machines capable of producing ever more complex surfaces, precise to a thousandth of a millimeter. CT machines irradiate prototypes after test runs to identify even the smallest changes. Lasers scan the exact form of the tire and the contact patch gets precisely measured. It, after all, provides the connection with the road. Even in the late 50s, it was already clear. What's important is a good, solid footprint. Solid too back then, with the hairstyles. For Inside Racing, reason enough to rummage around a bit in the Dunlop archives. Development stages, drawing board designs, and curiosities. Robots and computers practically only appeared in science fiction novels. And cars were still made with no great haste, by hand, with screwdriver and hammer. In the 60s, accident research increased. One aim, stable tires at higher speeds. The fact, however, that not only the cars and tires were on speed, but the advertising film crew too is shown by this original ad.
In the wet, our unique aquajets pump water clear, so you drive dry. And now into the rough. Our caterpillar shoulders shrug off obstacles, another of our inventions.
Well, the men in white coats then immediately took the drivers away. In the 60s, however, many key things happened, including on the tire front. Dunlop discovered the phenomenon of aquaplaning, and new technologies to prevent it were tested. A major issue, with testing and development done by every manufacturer. Drivers were informed using these animations, if they could stay awake, comprehensible even without 3D. This here is not the secret lab of the British Secret Service, but Dunlop's lab for testing high-speed tires. These clever guys are developing new treads, reading off thousands of signals, writing it all down, and practicing looking stern. Tire mission accomplished. However, lots of testing had always been done. But nothing comparable to what they got up to in the early 50s. Lean back and enjoy.
To Dunlop tubeless tires. We started by hammering in these nails, but these tests are not stunts. They involve everyday motoring hazards which could damage ordinary tires, but made much more severe for test purposes. The car we used was one of the many different makes in the Dunlop test fleet. Take curbing. This was our test version of it. Then there's the unexpected obstacle. We did 45 fast runs over a 7-inch curbstone. We dug ourselves a really nasty pothole, 17 inches deep, and crashed over it again and again. Cornering until the rubber smoked. Yet still, the tire-to-rim air seal remained intact. When the tires had cooled, they showed no loss of pressure. So we dropped it to 8 pounds and tried again. First, curbing. Then the curbstones. Full lock cornering to try to roll it off the rim. Remember, the nails are still there. Just look at that tire. And after all this, it was quite unharmed and the pressure was still 8 pounds.
Enough of black and white, and off to the loud, colorful 60s. Cars with 1,000 horsepower, interesting fitness moves, flared but very casual clothes, and views on the issues of sex, drugs, and safety. old fashions to one side, car and tire manufacturers continue to work together, developing better, safer tires to this day. In motor racing, only he who develops remains in front, and ideally that's done in partnership. A partnership that's a guarantee for the fans that for the next 50 years too, progress will never cease.
Inside Racing was brought to you by Dunlop